Here within the last couple of hours, we've also got more snow developing right now in western Montana. You're looking live on our U.S. Bank iCam in Great Falls, the camera bouncing around because the winds have really picked up here tonight. Temperature has actually gone back up thanks to that wind increasing. Winds are gusting here at the station right now to 34 miles per hour out of the southwest, and we have that high wind warning in effect for the Rocky Mountain Front, Great Falls, Cutbank, Helena, down to Livingston here until 11 o'clock in the morning. Winds are increasing right now. Overnight tonight, we could see some downed trees. We could see some downed power lines. It's going to be incredibly tough to drive on north-south roads here tomorrow morning. Notice the winds really ramping up here in the morning. This is 6 a.m. gusts upwards of about 50 to 60 miles per hour on the Rocky Mountain Front and extending out over the plains. It'll stay windy through late morning, and then the winds will taper off, I think, late tomorrow afternoon. Then we focus in on our next weather maker that's going to bring the heavy snow. Strong area of low pressure developing as we speak to our west. That's going to come in here bringing abundant moisture off the Pacific Ocean, while at the same time cold air diving south out of Canada, the two combining to create all of this snow that we're going to be getting here in the next couple of days. Here's future track at 5 o'clock in the morning. It is going to be snowing very heavily here on the Rocky Mountain Front. Places like Marias Pass and Rogers Pass getting in on some heavy snow. In fact, at times 1 to 2 inches per hour falling. So the snowfall rates are going to be very intense here. For the north, we're going to see a cold front drop south out of Canada tomorrow, and that's going to bring initially a rain snow mix followed by some light snow tomorrow evening over the plains. In the last couple of hours, I've seen some drier air try to work into some of the models here, and so I'm not expecting as much snow for places like Great Falls and Helena down to Butte, but this light snow is just going to continue off and on here up north through Tuesday, and it's still going to be coming down in the mountains through Tuesday. Then on Wednesday, I think we'll get into some light snow here all across north central Montana before this first round of snow begins to move out. Here's the updated snow forecast through Wednesday. Again, lower amounts of snow, an inch or less, Great Falls, Helena down to Butte. Still expecting 1 to 4 feet of snow here in the Rockies, and then 1 to 3 inches, as much as maybe 3 to 5 on the High Line. Mountain passes are going to get hit hard through Wednesday. 3 to 4 feet for Marias Pass up there to the north on Highway 2. It's going to be very rough going here. Kings Hill Pass, 1 to 1.5 feet. Rogers Pass, 8 to 12 inches. 3 to 5 for McDonald and 1 to 3 inches for Boulder Hill. Behind this first round of snow, very cold air diving south out of Canada. This is Christmas Eve. We're looking at high temperatures in the single digits and teens, and you add in a little bit of wind, it's going to feel even colder. Here's the next 7, 45 for your Monday, 33 on Tuesday, so it's going to get colder here. We'll see some light snow Tuesday and Wednesday, but again, I'm not expecting this first round to be a big deal, at least for lower elevations here. 27 Wednesday, and then the cold, cold air moves in, highs in the single digits as we head into Christmas Eve. We're talking lows close to zero, if not below zero. It is going to get brutally cold just in time for Christmas. Coming up in